Hi everyone, welcome to my channel Intentional Living Space. I'm your friend Purvi and I make videos on minimalism and self-development. Friends, if you are new here, I welcome you to this channel, and if you have come back after watching the previous videos, I'm so happy. I hope that you like my content and you are getting some value out of it. So friends, today's topic is really interesting and relevant to most of us, which is how to live with non-minimalist, right? Now, this is so important because one, the awareness about minimalism is very limited, at least in the country that I stay in. And second, very few of us are blessed with ideal families where everyone in the family, right from your parents to your sibling, to your spouse, to your children, are minimalist. Have you ever heard of one? Let me know in the comments below if you have. I would love to know you guys and how you guys operate. So without further discussion on that, let's move on to the topic. So friends, before we move on to this video, I would like to tell you to subscribe to my channel and like and share as much as you can, because only then will this channel grow and only then will I be motivated to make more videos. So now back to the topic. Living with non-minimalists. Okay, so this becomes really tricky because most of us, at least in India, the older generations are opposite of minimalism. Yeah, kind of. I mean, they are the ones who are so attached to everything and they don't find any reason to declutter anything. So traditionally, every year there is one festival according to the religion the person follows where they involve spring cleaning into action, okay, and they typically clean out all the things in the house. So they will pull out all the stuff, clean the shelves, clean the floors, the ceiling, the walls, and put everything back again. But they will not really go through the things, and that is why nobody ever throws anything in India. And that is little sad because living with such a person is even more difficult, because now that you know you are following a certain way and the other person is just not throwing anything, it can get on your nerves. So I have some tips for you which I have practiced and they have worked, you know, in their reasonable amount they have worked with me. So I'll share that with you. Number one is know your boundaries. Friends, this is the most important thing, or fundamental thing I would say, about living with non-minimalists. First of all, you must have a clear understanding that there are two kinds of things, okay, two kind of stuff. One is your purely personal stuff and second are your shared, you know, items. Purely personal stuff is typically something that only you use. You are completely accountable for it and you have the full responsibility to keep it, throw it, maintain it and store it. So this typically includes everything, probably, I mean, everything we wear, clothing, bags, shoes, accessories. It also includes our work equipments and tools. It also includes our hobby supplies, or, you know, whatever we like to pursue, you know, which are only specific to us. They are our belongings and we are responsible for them. And the second type, the category, is the shared items. Now, shared items are typically things that everyone in the house uses. So to give you an example, things in the kitchen. Nobody has an ownership that this one member owns all the kitchen items. Or things in your bathroom or things in your living room. The furniture is used by all. The products are used by all. So this is something that you share with others. So the first and the foremost thing is to know your boundaries. What things are yours alone and what things are your shared resources. Now the second point is declutter of acceptable range items. Now what do I mean by this thing? I'm just making jargons, haven't I? I love that actually. No, I will explain myself. So I hope the first point is clear between a demarcation of your personal things and the shared resources. Now the second point is that out of all the things that you share with other members of your family, you do have the right, the liberty and the authority to declutter things from that which are of acceptable range. So what I mean by this is, if your bathroom has so many products which are empty but nobody has taken the responsibility of throwing them, you can go ahead and throw them. They are over, the product is over. and you know nobody's using them. Somebody is just not taking the ownership to throw them. You can do that. Another example, anything that is torn, damaged, you know, deteriorated or even harmful for the environment can be decluttered by you. I'll give you an example. So my mother had kept so many plastic spoons in the kitchen, and she had kept so many plastic containers as well as plastic bags, you know, the typical mom thing, just in case items. And then after having asked her, I told her, can I, you know, throw these? And she didn't like the idea. So she said, no, we require it when we are traveling and all of that. And then she was out for, you know, for some work that day. And I said, I'm not going to keep those items. So I took all those plastic items and I disposed it off. So friends, now somebody might say you did the wrong thing. Well, according to me, I did the right thing because it was in the acceptable range. I did not touch her sentimental item or her item, which was, you know, she uses every day. Plastic is generally harmful for the environment and nobody should keep it in their house. So I did do that in the shared spaces. So you are allowed to actually declutter things which are of acceptable range, you know, in the shared spaces. Now the third point is influencing. This is fairly simple, friends. Sometimes when you cannot convince your family members to follow your lifestyle, you become influencers, right? In-house influencers. It's a great thing actually to do. So what you can do is, if family members are observing your latest kind of trends, like you are suddenly cleaning your things, you are donating your old clothes, you are decluttering and discarding old objects, electronics, whatever, they are intrigued. Oh, what is she up to? You know, why is she doing all this? And then when they see the aesthetic look of your wardrobe or your whatever, like your cupboard, they might be influenced. I'll give you this example. So initially, when I started off reading about minimalism, I was very much motivated to see how this works. And I decluttered a large amount of my really old clothes, like college clothes. And I don't know why I had kept it, but I did keep it and I decluttered. And suddenly my wardrobe is looking really nice, neat and everything. And my husband was so motivated. I mean, he was like, wow, this looks really nice. I mean, I should also look into my clothes. And then probably some weeks later, he was also, you know, looking in his cupboard to throw some stuff which is, you know, very, very old. So you can influence others. It's the best thing actually if they are learning something from you without you having to tell them. So that is my third tip. Now my fourth tip is that you can ask the right questions before anyone in your family decides to go for a large purchase, okay, which is common to all of you. Now, example, if there is someone in the family who says, I want to buy a treadmill, or it could be any piece of furniture, like somebody wants to buy a really elaborate couch or something, assuming you already have one couch and they want to buy another one. So you could actually, in the family discussion, introduce certain questions that could help them to understand why they exactly want to buy it. So you could ask questions like, why do you need it? Okay, how often are you going to use it? Are there any alternatives to this particular purchase? Can we rent or borrow it? And fifth and the most important thing, where are you going to store it? Now, once you introduce these thought-provoking questions in your family decisions, other people are going to start thinking about their decision, you know, whether it was a fickle idea, whether it was influenced by someone, or they impulsively want to buy something, or really it's a need. Once you start throwing these questions at others, they might realize on their own that maybe that was not really important. So that's an option. And friends, the last tip is very simple. Be sensitive to others. So I'll just say one thing. We are minimalists, okay? And if tomorrow somebody tells us that you have to leave this lifestyle and become a maximalist or a hoarder or a collector, or you know just embrace the materialistic lifestyle, are you going to do that? Probably not. It's going to be really difficult, or it will not, you will be so strong on your ground that you don't want to do it. Similarly, the people who are currently not minimalists also feel the same way about their life decisions. They are not interested in, you know, decluttering and living minimally. They are okay with their things. So let's be respectful towards that. Let's understand that we cannot really control or force anyone into any kind of lifestyle. And as I said in my first point, know your boundaries. You know, this is the most important thing. You can live a minimalist life within your boundaries and nobody is stopping you. You can, you know, make your own decisions with your own things. So friends, I hope that you like this video. Do let me know in the comments, you know, whether you are living with a non-minimalist and how are you dealing with that. Have you ever tried to convince them? Did you talk to them, you know, about what is minimalism and why you are following it? What has been your experience? I would really love to know. And with me, as I told you, that my husband already got inspired and now we are together having a common vision. So yes, I'm one of the lucky ones. But of course, when it comes to my parents and my in-laws, they are of the little bit of the, you know, not completely minimalist, but yeah, they are also learning some new ideas. So that's all from my side and I will see you again next week. Also, let me know in the comments whether, you know, these sort of topics are interesting you and what sort of topics should I also talk on. Till such time. Bye-bye.